I'm the girl from Beregszasz. My name is Margot, and this is my story. 1942, my sister Gizzy was working in Slough in a factory making periscope parts. There's a photograph of her, which was let out. The first year I came to Britain, 1942. I spent my holidays in Maidenhead with my sister. That's when I had my lunch at the milk bar. I did a naughty thing, I presume. And of course, I was a chatterbox, I suppose, when I was a child. Even I'm a chatterbox now, they say. And I went and I like to sit on the bar stools. So I went on the bar stool, and these two officers came in and began to talk to me. And I said, "Oh, I've got two sisters." And I said, "How pretty they are," and this and that. And we just live down there, work here. My sister works as a hairdresser. And of course, I invited them, which I forgot, of course. It was summer, actually, and the windows was open, and then I was upstairs in our bedroom, and I heard something stop. I looked out, and these were the two officers, GI officers, and I froze to death because I thought, now I'm going to get it from my sisters, which I did. And then they came, of course, in and was looking easy chair, but very big and sort of massive. And I hid behind there. And she said, "If you do that again, I'll kill you." I never forget that one. So that was my thing with the first Americans, I suppose. And then of course my sister met my brother-in-law, Daryl. And my other sister had a boyfriend called Mac, and they were, I didn't know what they were transferred, but they didn't say where. Of course they didn't know, but they took me out, my two sisters, to look for them, but they were marching out, and the field was full of sweets and chewing gum, and of course they sent me in there. I packed it all in my skirt, of course. And they nearly killed me again because I didn't do what they told me to do. But they caught Mac, and all he said is, "Daryl is ahead. We're going, we don't know where." That's all we knew. Daryl was in the 9th Engineer Command. Mac died. Daryl survived. And of course, he had to go through all those things in life. He was a very good man, and a very loving, really. He was good to us, he was good to me as a child, and always wrote to me even when I was in the school in Hinton Hall. All of us children went to the VE Day party in our street in Western Road, and the parents were there. The mayor came down to see us. We had a very nice time for us kids, and were happy that the war was over. Daryl even wanted my brother and my sister, my other sister, to go out to America after them, but it didn't happen. I don't know how. They know. by the time this all happened, I was back in my country. My sister was going to America, my eldest sister Gizzy, and so there was nobody to look after me, and my mother was asking them to take care of me. Of course, no one did, so I had to go back with them. And then we went back. My mother didn't want us to go. And I remember that scene, my father holding onto the handle of the kitchen door and begging mother for the passports. And mother said, no, 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 but and she gave in. But she felt something's going to go wrong. And she asked my sisters to look after me. My brother was in the army, so he was in Holland or Belgium at that time. And going back with them in Prague, we stayed for 2 weeks. A lot of people came back to England who were normal. My father, sorry to say he wasn't. So we went back to Beregszasz. We didn't get our house back straight away, of course. We lived in the center, in a flat. Wednesday, the 5th of December, 1945, the train took us into a snowy Beregszasz station. There was a one-horse open sleigh waiting for us. I felt so proud sitting in the sleigh, and they put covers on our knees, and off we went. And as the horse was running, it had the bells on near its ears, and was tingling, tingling, going like that. And I felt so proud sitting there. My mother put me in the guest house bed. It was very cold, and I forgot that she told me that my uncles are going to pick me up. So two men came in. I thought, who are they? I wonder. And then, of course, they said that I'm your uncle, Motu, and I'm your uncle, Shani. And they took me to my grandfather's. When I went back to Beregszasz, I was 10.5 years old, so I had to go to school. And I couldn't speak my own language. I couldn't speak Hungarian. So I had to learn Hungarian, Russian, and Ukrainian, three languages at once. I must have been very clever. This is my story.